I have the new Mavic 3 drone, and I'm going to compare it against the Air 2S and the Mavic 2 Pro. First, let me show you how it fits in the bag here. The Mavic 3 is a big drone, especially compared to all the other folding drones, but it's not that big in the bag because all you need to carry is a controller and the drone. Compared to the much smaller Air 2S, I have to carry a controller, an extra battery, and a charger. This is kind of a big deal for me. The Mavic 3 charges with USB-C, so I can use any charger, including the charger I already carry with me for things like my laptop. I can charge it in my car. That adds a lot to the versatility. Let's get these things unpacked and see how they fly.
Wing out the gimp.
Let's go through the specs first. This is the Air 2S. It's only about $1,000. It shoots 4K at 60 frames per second.
The Air 2S is 20 megapixels with an equivalent 22 millimeters f8.4 lens.
I'll discuss why that doesn't match the specs in a bit. This is the Mavic 2 Pro. It goes for about $1,600 now. It has a 1-inch sensor just like the Air 2S.
The Mavic 2 Pro is 20 megapixels with an equivalent 28 millimeters f8.4 lens.
This one, unlike the other two drones, uses the older style controller with the phone connection at the bottom. I don't like this controller as much, but it does fold up substantially smaller. The Air 2S and the 3 have the same controller. This new Mavic 3 shoots 4K at a full 120 frames per second. And the sensor is about twice as big with a micro four thirds sensor.
The Mavic 3 is an equivalent 24 millimeters f5.6 lens. That's more than a full stop faster than the other two drones. It also has a 162 millimeter f24 equivalent telephoto lens. I put each drone at 30 frames per second and their highest resolution. Even on my 30-inch 4K monitor squinting up close to the screen, I really can't call a winner. They seem indistinguishable. I will say the Air 2S has different colors from the two Hasselblad lenses, which are more muted. If you shoot at 60 frames per second like we do, you will see a difference upgrading to the Mavic 3 from the Mavic 2 Pro. The Mavic 2 Pro has to drop to 2.7K to film at 60 frames per second. And if you freeze motion and zoom way in, you can definitely see more detail in the Mavic 3. If I didn't stop and squint, I didn't notice a difference. If you're shooting 4K 60, honestly, the Air 2S is the drone to beat. Most of the time, we couldn't see any difference. Like, check out how beautiful this orbit is, even slowed down 50%. But there were times when the Air 2S was less than professional. Look at the crazy moiré on this building. The Mavic 2 Pro showed a little bit of that, but the Mavic 3 showed none. And if you were being paid for a real estate shoot, well, only one of them would produce sellable results. I care about composition, and sometimes I want to tilt the camera up, fill the frame with sky, and put the horizon at the bottom of the frame. When stationary, the Mavic 3 tilted way back. When flying upwind, it positioned the horizon about one-third of the way from the bottom of the frame. By comparison, this is the farthest back I could tilt the Air 2S, whether stationary or flying into the wind. This really limits your composition choices. The Mavic 2 Pro tilted way back when stationary, but as soon as I started moving upwind, it tilted down until the horizon was about center of the frame. When I forced it to tilt back again, it showed props in the shot. This is a big win for the Mavic 3, which never showed props. That'll ruin your shots. Throughout our filming and my real-world experience with these drones, the Air 2S and the Mavic Pro regularly show props in the shot, or they show shadows from the props, and I've never once seen it with the Mavic 3. DJI finally fixed this problem, thank you. The Mavic 3 advertises stronger signal to power through obstacles and interference, but that wasn't the case. All three drones failed at exactly the same spot consistently. Let's talk about battery life, and keep in mind, DJI forces you to land at about 20%. The Air 2S had the worst battery life. After a 12 and a half minute flight, it was at about 29%, so just about ready to die. The Mavic 2 Pro and Mavic 3 did the same flight almost a minute faster because they were able to take higher speeds flying upwind. They're just more powerful drones. The Mavic 2 Pro had about 47% battery after that same flight. The Mavic 3 had about 57% battery left. I don't usually stay in the air that long, but if you do, get the Mavic 3. I'm gonna cover low light video and still images in a second, but first, you gotta listen to me rant.
I'm gonna complain about six things about the Mavic 3. The first is that they abuse crop factor. Whenever a manufacturer puts things in 35 millimeter equivalent terms, that's a use of crop factor. This is a 24 millimeter lens in 35 millimeter equivalent terms, but it's only physically a 12 millimeter lens. It's okay to put it in equivalent terms, but they don't apply the crop factor to the f/2.8 aperture. That they give you the physical number. Really, it's a 24 millimeter f/5.6. Every manufacturer does this, but the weird thing is that this does not show the capabilities of this versus the other DJI drones, because DJI has always pulled this little trick. This has a sensor that's twice as big, and thus it gathers about twice as much light as the other two f/2.8 sensors. Complaint number two, the telephoto lens here sucks. They don't specifically tell you that, but it's very limited. It's only an f/4 lens. It has a teeny tiny sensor. It doesn't record 4K 60 or 4K 120. The pictures aren't very good. They're very blurry, and honestly, I can't really imagine ever using it. Complaint number three, this advertises 360 obstacle sensing heavily, but it does not sense obstacles from the side unless you're in very restrictive modes that I would never ever use. Normal flight, it does not detect side-to-side motion, but I really, really need that because I always do side-to-side orbits, and multiple times I've crashed into things because when you're doing a side-to-side orbit, you're staring at your screen, you're not staring at the drone, and thus you have no peripheral vision and it just crashes into stuff. DJI even says they will not replace it under your DJI warranty if you crash into things going sideways. Why advertise 360 avoidance if you're not going to provide it?
So obstacle avoidance will still fly you sideways into a tree, but it will also stop abruptly if you try to fly over this fence even with a solid 1 foot clearance.
Complaint number four, a bunch of features aren't ready for this yet. They wanted to ship it for Christmas even though it wasn't finished, so it doesn't have really important features like Active Track 5.0. But they advertise Active Track 5.0, and I thought I was gonna get it when I bought it, but I can't test that yet, so subscribe and we'll test it in like a month or 2 months when it's actually ready. Complaint number five is that H on the front lens. That stands for Hasselblad, which was once an extremely reputable company. They made big medium format cameras for professional commercial photographers. They even sent one to the moon, but their cameras couldn't keep up with the tech from companies like Canon and Sony. And they hit hard financial times. And then DJI, the Chinese company, bought Hasselblad. This was, I promise, not designed by Hasselblad. Hasselblad has no expertise in tiny little compact lenses. That's not even their field. It's just brand engineering. They slap an H on there and charge you so much more for nothing.
Okay, maybe I gotta cut back on the coffee. Here's some soothing B-roll as I drive home. Back home, I did a more controlled image quality comparison. These are raw files processed in Lightroom Classic. Zooming way in, the Mavic Air 2S actually looks better, even though it's less expensive. The Mavic 3 has significant amounts of false color that make me think DJI might have left off an anti-aliasing filter. I see this throughout the image. The older Air 2S actually looks better. In the corners, the Air 2S shows more detail as well. Compare the Mavic 2 Pro to the Mavic 3, and we see again the same problems with the Mavic 3 that the Mavic 2 Pro lacks. Once again, corner detail looks better on the Mavic 2 Pro. The Mavic 3 includes a telephoto lens that brings faraway subjects closer, allowing you to film or photograph things while being out of sight and out of sound. These side-by-side photos show the wide-angle lens and the telephoto lens. Let's zoom in to see how much more detail you get. Yeah, that's a lot of detail. This is going to be a great tool for paparazzi and stalkers and, well, maybe a few inspectors. Here's another wide versus telephoto example. Yeah, TMZ would definitely pay more for the telephoto photo, so maybe this drone will pay for itself. An adjustable aperture gives you some control over the amount of background blur. Here we see the same photo taken at f/2.8 and f/11. Note that I created this specifically to show as much background blur as possible. We'll probably never shut the aperture down for stills, but for video, you can use it to fine tune the shutter speed and follow the 180 rule. You can see here a little more motion blur when I follow the 180 rule. Photographers do a lot of their work in the golden hour or the blue hour after dusk. So let's see how these three drones compare in low light conditions. Will the Mavic 3's bigger sensor make a difference? In low light compared to the Mavic 2 Pro, the Mavic 3 captured more of the colors in the sky. Also note the different aspect ratios. The Mavic 2 Pro has an aspect ratio more like traditional 35mm cameras, while the Mavic 3 has a more square aspect ratio that might be more useful for things like Instagram. The Air 2S and Mavic 2 Pro had better image quality and good light, but in low light, the Mavic 3 was significantly sharper thanks to that big sensor. Capturing a high dynamic range scene and recovering the highlights and shadows, the Mavic 3's bigger sensor does produce cleaner, more colorful images. In the Mavic 3, you can see just a little bit of the brick detail in this chimney, whereas it's completely lost in noise in the Mavic Air 2S. If you might be shooting stills during civil twilight, like for real estate photography, upgrade to the Mavic 3. Otherwise, save $1,200 and get the Air 2S. To test night photography and long exposure stabilization, I photographed the same scene at 2 seconds on all of the drones. The first thing I noticed is that the Mavic 3 had incredible problems autofocusing that the other cameras didn't. The Air 2S and the Mavic 2 Pro both nailed focus on every shot. At first, the Mavic Air 2S seems to have more detail until you realize that this is all just noise. The larger sensor of the Mavic 3 actually produced sharper, better images. The Mavic 2 Pro images looked very similar to the Air 2S, which again was slightly worse than the Mavic 3. So the Mavic 3 wins in low light. Now let's test video after dark. I hovered each drone over my house. The Air 2S showed a lot of noise, but pretty good color. Surprisingly, the Mavic 2 Pro's Hasselblad lens did the worst in this test, with extremely prominent noise and bad color and very little shadow detail. The Mavic 3's bigger sensor produced cleaner images and showed far more shadow detail. Here's a look at the results side by side. For low light work, the Mavic 3 is the clear winner.
So which drone should you buy? Most people should buy the Mavic Air 2S. This is still kind of our daily drone and nobody has ever complained about the footage. It flies fantastic, it's light and inexpensive, and it's just a really good quality product. The Mavic 2 Pro at about $1,600, still a great drone. You don't necessarily need to upgrade, but it is kind of obsolete. The new drone really outdoes it in every single way, especially higher frame rates, if that's something that you're looking for. Finally, should you buy the Mavic 3? Most people shouldn't. Honestly, most people will never notice if you're publishing on something like YouTube.